Welcome to Adventure Terrain Ventures. I'm Aurel David here. And today we're going to talk in this video a little bit about trading, demand, supply, and candlesticks. So let me start off with a trade which I'm on right now, and then we'll little dive in deeper into candlestick charts. So what you see here is a chart of Aura Pharma. As you can see here, this is a 75-minute chart of Aura Pharma. I got into this trade yesterday. Let me give you a brief reasoning as to why I got into this trade. As you can see over here on this chart, a few candles, you know, and a period of indecision. You know, you can see that demand and supply are in balance here. So, you know, the market during this whole period is neither moving up nor moving down. But suddenly, you see a sharp upward move in price. Definitely, some buying has come over here, causing the price to move higher. So what I do is I usually mark this area as an area of demand. Why? Because strong buying started coming over here. So next time if price comes back to this area of demand, I would like to buy. So that's exactly what happened yesterday. Close towards the end of the day, price suddenly collapsed and came into the area of demand. And I was very glad to buy it at my entry price. So the entry price is 582. And I went on holding on to it. And today I got a nice upward move in price. I kept my stop loss just below the area of demand at 565. And I held on to the position. So as you can see, the price sharply moved higher and then fell shy of my target. So my target was 615.95, but I'm still holding on to the position. Probably I'll have my target tomorrow. If not, what I have done already is I have moved my stop loss just above the entry price here. So in case the market suddenly drops down, I will be out at break even. So it would be a no risk trade for me right here. Okay, so let's dive a little deeper into these candlesticks and see how we can use this in our trading. So if you look at a candle very closely, this is what you will see. A candle has a body and two wicks, the upper wick and the lower wick. They also call it the topping tail and the bottoming tail. So the lowest part of the tail is the low for the day. The highest part of the tail is the high for the day. The lower part portion of the body is the open, and the upper portion of the body is the close. So since the open is lower and the close is higher, this is a bullish candle. And that's why they colored it green. A lower opening, maybe price dropped all the way till here, then went all the way up till here, the high up formed a new high and then closed somewhere here. So ultimately during this period the market went up. So this is what we call a bullish candle, and we color it usually green. So it gives us a clear indication that during this period, the market went up. Now, what period does a candle represent? A candle can represent any period. So a candle can represent a 5-minute period. It can represent a 15-minute period. It can represent a 60-minute period. It can represent one full day. Or it could even represent a week or a month. So there are different time frames that a candle can represent. Let's look at this candle on the right. What's the difference can you spot compared to this candle? Yes, in this candle, the open is higher and the close is lower. The high and low remains the same. And even this candle has a upper wick, or is called as the topping tail, the lower wick, or also called as the bottoming tail, and a body. Now, why have they colored this red? Because during this period, the market came down. So market opened somewhere here. It made a new high, came all the way down till here, and then closed somewhere here, but lower than the open. So during this period, the market came down. And that's why this candle is called a bearish candle. Again, this bearish candle can represent any period, just like a bullish candle. It could be for a day, or it could be a week, a month, or even an intraday time frame like 5 minutes, 15 minutes, 60 minutes, etc. Now, there are many ways one can use these candles in trading. One such way we will talk about today, that is to identify buying pressure and selling pressure in the market. Now, let's look at this candle. If you notice, this candle has a bottoming tail. It doesn't have any topping tail. And it has a very long bottoming tail, right? So what would have happened during this period? So market would have opened over here. Then you would see that market fell all the way till here. Then from here, again, market picked up all the way up again and closed higher than where it opened, almost at the high of the day. So that's why this candle is colored green, and it is a bullish candle. Now, this long bottoming tail that you see indicates buying pressure. Why? Because after the market came down all the way till here, it sharply rose. So this indicates that there is buying pressure. Okay, so this long bottoming tail always indicates buying pressure. Now let's look at the candle on the right. What happened in the market during this candle period? Market opened over here. Then it went up till here, but it couldn't sustain this up move, and it sharply dropped all the way till here. That means it closed lower than the open at the bottom of the day. So this long topping tail here, it indicates selling pressure. So whenever you see these long tails, either bottoming tails or topping tails, you can really expect a change in price direction. So for example, if you see price dropping and then you see a bottoming tail, you can expect that market would probably move up from here because there is a lot of buying pressure. Same way, if you see market on a rise and then suddenly you see a candle which has a topping tail which is so long, you can see selling pressure, so you can expect a price to turn down from there. So let us see on a price chart how we can actually decide when to buy and sell, looking at buying and selling pressures. Let me show you another trade that I took this week in IDFC. So this was on a 15-minute chart. Yeah, there it is. I had identified this trade many days back, and I had actually identified this area of supply, and I was waiting for a very long time for price to retrace back into this area of supply. So as you can see, a few days back, price did retrace to my area of supply. After this down move, prices came up and retraced back into this area of supply. So if you can see right here, there is a candle over here that exhibits selling pressure. Would you agree? A long topping tail, followed by a very sharp move to the downside. Now, when price retraced back, you can see a lot more candles with topping tails. There's one over here. There's one more over here. There's one more over here. Now, after all these candles exhibiting selling pressure, you can see that we had a sharp move to the downside. If you were trading this stock intraday, and if you had gone short, at an entry price of 51.1, you would have been able to exit at a smart profit at the close or the end of the day at 50.65. If you were trading in futures, you could have held on to this short position. Next day, market shot up again, but it really could not go beyond the area of supply. You can see it formed a very long topping tail and then slowly drifted down, and you know, towards almost before the end of the day, it achieved my target. So as you can see, using candlestick patterns with buying pressure or selling pressure, you can, along with the areas of demand and supply, you can combinedly use them very effectively to identify buying and selling trading opportunities. Let us now look at the chart of Nifty, the broader market. Where is demand and where is supply? If you have watched my last week's video, I had actually identified this area of supply. And we had discussed last week that, you know, once prices entered this area of supply, we are going to see some bearishness. So as you can see, price touched this area of supply and then dropped down. But after that, again, we went higher and it went deeper into the area of supply. And today, again, the market has dropped down. I expect that before the market goes up further, it needs to come to an area of demand. Markets usually tend to oscillate between areas of demand and supply. So this is an area of demand which I have identified. Now, when you join a course where I teach you about demand and supply, the module is called the Stock Market Model Street. You will learn exactly how to mark or identify these areas of demand and supply. So as per the rules that I use for identifying these areas, I have marked this area as an area of demand. So it would not be wrong to say that, you know, market has to first come down at least till about 10,630 before it actually starts going higher. However, since this area of supply was already tested once over here, now this area of supply has become weaker. And prices have gone quite deep into this area of supply. I would not like to keep any short positions as of now in the Nifty. However, if price drops down to this area of demand, I will not hesitate to take long positions. Why? Because in higher time frame charts, so this is the daily chart, let me move to a monthly chart, which is a higher time frame chart of Nifty. You can see there is absolutely no area of supply. So I wouldn't mind buying Nifty if it does come down till here. Till then, I will not do anything. Stay out of the market. Wait for this area of supply to get breached and then maybe think of taking any kind of long positions. So that's it for today. Thanks for watching. This is Aurel David. You can visit our website, that is adventureterrainventures.com, for any further and more detailed information regarding our courses. Stay tuned for more videos. Goodbye.